The illegal jumping would stop, they say, if they could only jump from the best cliffs in the country. But those are in forbidden territory, in the state and national parks. And that's where you'll find the base jumper's own Everest, Yosemite's El Capitan, at 3,600 feet, as tall as three Empire State Buildings. This is the ultimate jump. Base jumping wasn't always forbidden here. Yosemite gave it a three-month trial period, but base jumpers repeatedly broke the rules and didn't get the necessary permits, so the sport was banned.
I would say we've tried it and it doesn't work.
Dennis Galvin is the deputy director of the National Park Service. He says they banned jumping for a lot of reasons.
National parks weren't set up so that everybody could recreate in every way they wanted in those parks. They were set up to be saved for future generations.
Base jumpers will say that they are taxpayers, the national parks belong to everyone, it's their right to jump in national parks.
No, that's not true. There are certain rights we're all given under the Constitution. Base jumping is not listed as one of them.
Base jumpers point out that the parks do allow other dangerous sports, like hang gliding and rock climbing. They accuse the Park Service of discrimination.
See ya!
And flouting the law, they continue to jump. Some 6,000 illegal jumps off El Capitan in the last 20 years. One of them was done by a man named Frank Gambale. After his jump, he saw park rangers closing in on him, so he made a run for it. He tried to escape by swimming across a river and drowned.
After the death of Frank Gambale, there was quite an uproar. There were many, many rumors and threats of a mass jump.
In fact, these four decided to jump from El Capitan in protest.
Civil disobedience you're talking about. Mm-hmm. People think about that in relation to Mahatma Gandhi, Martin Luther King. Is this really appropriate civil disobedience?
Yes.
Yes.
This is a cause. It's our cause. It might not be your cause, but it's our cause.
There was a fifth protester that day, Jan Davis, the wife of stunt filmmaker Tom Sanders. He was there to film the protest.
My wife had been base jumping for 15 years. You know, she was definitely the queen of base jumping and the queen of skydiving.
9, 8.
On that day, to make a statement, Jan Davis dressed like a prisoner. She knew the Park Service would confiscate her gear, so she didn't use her best, most expensive equipment. Three others who had jumped before her had already been arrested and handcuffed. Jan Davis was next.
You were there filming that day. What happened?
Well, I saw her exit, and I wasn't even concerned for her safety there. I know that sounds ridiculous, but there are jumps that I worried a lot about. But this is a very, very forgiving base jump.
1, 2, 1. See ya!
And I saw her exit, and as far as I could tell, she looked like she had a good, stable exit. There was never any tumbling. And she just continued to fall and fall and fall. And there was a time where I thought, okay, come on, pull, 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 you know. And she liked free fall. But then she continued to fall, and once I saw the trees come into frame, I knew it was too late.
Jan Davis's death was the sixth in Yosemite since the Park Service banned base jumping.
Jan Davis is dead because of Park Service policy and her decisions. Frank Gambale is dead because of Park Service policy and his decisions. It happens, and they could be more reasonable.
That's an incredibly serious charge to say that the Parks Department is killing these people.
They are. They are too overzealous in their persecution of base jumpers.
I reject that charge.
The National Park Service accepts no responsibility for these or any other base jumping deaths. And it points out that Jan Davis's death was a tragic accident caused by equipment failure. Base jumpers were shaken by Jan Davis's death, but not deterred.
Let me just ask you this, though. The death of Jan Davis didn't change your mind?
Absolutely not. It strengthened my belief in my cause.
Yeah. Why?
She died doing something that she loved.
Did that protest then set back your cause?
Yes. It did.
This is a sport that's turning you into criminals.
We're not criminals. Only in the eyes of the people who want to restrict us from participating in our sport.
According to the National Park Service, there was a decline in base jumping in the 5 years after Jan Davis's death. But in 2007, it made something of a comeback. Jumpers said that new high-tech equipment made the sport safer than ever. That may be, but it was still illegal, with fines of up to $2,000 if you got caught base jumping in Yosemite or any other national park. Park officials admit that it's tough to enforce the law because jumpers are quick and usually take the plunge early in the morning before the rangers are on duty. El Capitan in 2007 was still the mecca for base jumpers from all over the world.